As in all life, our communities are forever changing. People come and go. Babies are born, elders die. Family dynamics change as communities expand and contract. Some artists have come and gone, whilst others have settled here long term. And why wouldn't they? The environment is so diverse, beautiful, and rich in inspiration. Wombat is by no means the first organised arts group in the region. The Arcadian Arts Festival long preceded the Autumn Festival. The Balan Art and Craft Society has existed for more than 30 years. There has been and continues to be a strong quilters group, to name a few. Within the 10 years that Wombat has existed, new waves of artistic energy have moved into the community, continuing to add richness and diversity to our local culture. Our 10-year celebration not only celebrates Wombat's achievements in relation to the arts, but the growth in arts culture as a whole, where successful working relationships between individual artists, community groups, health agencies and Moorabool Shire have led to successful outcomes in terms of acknowledging, celebrating and valuing all forms of artistic expression. Who are these artists one keeps hearing about? Where do people with a passion for the arts cross paths? Where do they meet to discuss things, share ideas? How do they communicate? In relation to Moorabool Shire, is there an arts policy? Artists register? Where are the galleries and public art pieces? Is there a formalised arts group serving the Shire? Over 40 supporters of the arts attended the gathering at the Greendale Hotel. The energy experienced in the room as each person shared who they were and their interest in the arts was so inspiring and uplifting. As a result, a steering committee was formed. Wombat Regional Arts Network came into being and in time was affiliated with Regional Arts Victoria. With our mission statement and goals down on paper, the challenge to connect artists, art-related groups and supporters of the arts across the Moorabool Shire began. Regular meetings were held in Blackwood, Balan and Bacchus Marsh where people would share food, discuss ideas and where guest speakers in a range of arts disciplines spoke about their projects and journeys. In our first year, we operated as a steering committee. Then in 2001, Wombat was registered as an incorporated body and affiliated with Regional Arts Victoria. The first major project was the Wombat Travelling Art Show. 140 people of all ages across the Shire contributed to an art piece for the project. Each was given a piece of wood, donated by a local business, on which to create Who I Am. The purpose of the travelling show around the Shire was to get people of all ages involved in the arts at a grassroots level. Find out who were the artists and arts-interested people. Generate interest and support for Wombat. Start an arts register and mailing list. The first leg of the project was held in Blackwood in a tent at the Garden of St. Earth, followed by another event in Balan. The final celebration was held in Bacchus Marsh after pieces were installed on the wall in the Shire Hall, where the piece is still housed. There was a lot of arts energy in Blackwood at this point in time, which saw the Scarecrow exhibition at the Garden of St. Earth in September 2001, followed by two Sunday afternoon music recitals, also in September and October. In November 2001, Wombat members provided a tent with activities for children to support the Greendale Man of the Mountain Festival. Back in Balan, Wombat held the first Christmas in Balan 2001 street celebration. In April 2002, to support the Blackwood Woodchop Festival, Barbara Rossman organised the Flying of the Quilts exhibition. During 2001, Mayor Marg Card asked Wombat to submit some designs for a new honour board for Moorabool Shire Council. Since the amalgamation of Werribee, Bungaree, Ballyang, Balan and Bacchus Marsh Shires in 1994, there had not been a new honour board. Designs were submitted and the new board was completed in 2002. This was a collaborative effort. In December 2001, a small happening turned into a major publicity event for raising the profile of the arts in Moorabool Shire. As Jeff, Lou's partner, was driving past what was then the op shop, now the restored Bland News Building, he watched a large painting being taken off a Shire truck into the op shop. He went in and offered $20 for the painting. No one had any idea what it was or who it was by. When the painting came home to Lou's house, it was very evident that it was a painting of significance by Geelong artist Ray Reardon. Through research, it was found to be valued at somewhere between $3,000 and $4,000. It had been thrown out in a clean-up at the Shire and was one of many pieces of art that made up the Shire's art collection. Prior to the Balan and Bacchus Marsh Shire's amalgamation, Bacchus Marsh had an art collection which was lost after the Shires joined together. It had been forgotten about and only remembered when questions were asked about the op shop find. Thanks to Bacchus Marsh artist Jenny Hine, the collection was found in places throughout the Shire and brought together for an exhibition through Wombat. This was held in the Uniting Church Hall in Bacchus Marsh. Mayor Alan Comrie opened the exhibition and Ray Reardon was the guest speaker, reunited with his painting after many years. To support this exhibition and to raise funds, Wombat organised a postcard exhibition, where artists were asked to create an art piece the size of a postcard. These were donated by artists and silently auctioned, raising much needed funds to keep Wombat functioning. Following this exhibition, the Shire set up the CHAD Committee, Cultural, Historical and Artifacts Database, to ensure issues like the throwing away of the valuable Ray Reardon painting would not occur again. Lou represented Wombat and the arts on this committee. The CHAD Committee worked successfully for several years with Ballarat University to set up a database of artifacts of both historical and cultural significance. The scope of the project grew bigger and bigger, encompassing much more than just arts. A great deal of work was accomplished by this committee. However, after a restructuring of the Shire's directors and officers, the director of this committee left the Shire and the database is yet to be completed, particularly from an arts perspective. Sometime later, an historical advisory committee and the ACE, Arts, Culture and Events Committee, was established. This AGM was the beginning of some not the average AGMs where the business was over quickly, followed by a lot of fun. Christmas in Balan was celebrated for several years where Wombat coordinated street decorations and flags for the street which were hand-painted by local school children. Community workshops were provided for people to come along and decorate shoeboxes for window displays and to create Christmas decorations. The Balan Chamber of Commerce part-funded these activities. The main feature for the first 2 years was the Minnie Myers Christmas window displays created by Carol Callender, who put an enormous amount of time and energy into these displays that were most popular with local children. The windows were unveiled for the children with considerable pomp and ceremony and tall stories from Rob Leslie and Jamie Stone on the morning of the Lions Club Christmas Market with street performers, buskers and other entertainment. Whilst Carol was over at Sunbury one day, she spotted some huge Christmas bells in an op shop that had been discarded by another council. She purchased these for Wombat. Lou decorated them and, with John Cutler swinging off the top of a ladder, the bells were installed on poles along the main street. It was a huge effort by John, and then the bells had to come down again. The bells were a street feature at Christmas time for several years, until there were issues with power core, so the Shire took over hanging them. During this period, Sally Goldstraw was employed as the facilitator for CCBI, Community Capacity Building Initiative, and did an enormous amount of community consultation, investigating a range of successful projects across the region. CCBI took the lead with community Christmas celebrations in 2002, supported by Wombat, Balan District Health and Care, the Community House, Lions and Rotary Clubs, local schools, and other community organisations. It was a wonderful coming together event for the community. Six Santas set up residence in town, and over the month leading up to Christmas Day appeared in all sorts of places, on rooftops, in supermarket trolleys, in the video shop, and one went walkabout, never to return. Christmas in Berlin 2003 was also a major community celebration, as it linked in with the reopening of the refurbished Berlin Mechanics Institute and Community House. Wombat was instrumental in organising aspects of the celebrations, which included a band in the hall in the evening, street performers, and a major exhibition featuring local artists. The celebrations were organised by the Shire, Hall Committee members, and Wombat. It was an extraordinary exhibition, and would have sat with ease in any major gallery. It brought home to those who saw the exhibition the wealth of talent living in our communities. One thing stood out from this exhibition, that probably no more than 100 people actually saw it, giving some indication of the amount of work and education needed to give the arts and artists status in the community. Lou's comments, "I had to give a speech on behalf of Wombat, and when I got up to speak I lost it, sobbed my eyes out, and Sally had to fill in for a bit till I got my act together. I was extremely tired, physically and emotionally, from working on the Hall Committee and Wombat to get the reopening together, and overwhelmed at having these five extraordinary artists work together in the space. They were so giving and willing to show their work in the community. Nationally acclaimed artists exhibiting in Berlin. It was surreal. I couldn't believe we'd achieved it. Miranda played this really moody, moving piece on the cello. It was all too much, so emotional, and it was at this exhibition that we said, one day we'll have a Peter Blizzard sculpture in the street outside the hall. The need to keep lobbying the council to acknowledge these artists through the acquisition of their works became of great importance." One of the guiding principles for Wombat was to work with and support other community groups in the pursuit of raising the profile of the arts. Autumn on the Wall was our first event to support the Autumn Festival. Wombat distributed canvases to interested people of all ages to create their interpretation of autumn. The exhibition consisted of over 50 works and was shown in the conference room at the Mechanics Institute. The pieces have been grouped together and framed and continue to hang on the walls in the venue. The Wacky Birdhouse exhibition was also held at this time to support the Autumn Festival. Extreme Arts Makeover was instigated by Sarah Springfield, where people had the opportunity to come together to create art pieces from discarded objects. Wombat was successful in applying for funding from the Department of Victorian Communities to run the project. The event resulted in some fun sculptural pieces, mainly giant bugs, to enhance the external gallery space at the Mechanics Institute. Our July AGM was held in the Green Room. During the year, Wombat was an advisory committee for the Arts to Moorabool Shire. Funding for a dedicated arts officer was obtained by the Shire, and John Stevens was appointed by Moorabool and Hepburn Shires as a community culture and arts liaison officer. Wombat also supported the youth theatre group Bite. Members of Wombat were keen to foster street culture outside the Mechanics Institute, where people could gather, share stories, have fun, and enjoy coffee and food. And so, the first Café Bohemia was held in December. To set the scene, Wombat provided chairs, tables, a fortune teller, belly dancers, booked a mobile coffee man, provided nibbles and entertainment, and people just came along. It was a fabulous evening and the weather was kind. The event highlighted the need for a gathering place and the desire for a touch of cafe culture in the community. Also in December 2005, Wombat once again decorated the street for Christmas. These flags, in the style of traditional Buddhist prayer flags, were made by Wombat volunteers. The material was donated by the Berlin and District Community House, and school children from both Berlin Primary School and St. Bridget's wrote Christmas wishes on the red flags. In Tibetan culture, flags have prayers written on them, and when blown in the breeze, those prayers are sent up to the heavens. Interestingly, there was a reaction from some members in the community. Why would we use Buddhist Tibetan prayer flags for a Christian celebration? The Santas appeared in the streets, minus the one that had got stolen earlier. Such was the success of the first Cafe Bohemia, people kept asking when the next one was. So in February of 2006, the scene was set. Chairs, tables, umbrellas, coffee and nibbles to share, with the odd drop of wine served in teapots and cups, in the street outside the Balland Mechanics Institute. People came along, others were brave enough to get up and entertain, and a good time was had by all. There were many performers over the period of the Cafe Bohemia gatherings, including Nina Roxburgh, fire twirling, musicians Megan and John, local belly dancers, fortune tellers, a squeeze box player, musicians of all sorts, all highlighting the variety of local talent. After two successful gatherings, Cafe Bohemia concept was adopted by other groups. Wombat had set the scene, had let people know about it, and the event evolved. The coffee man came again, and heated discussions followed within the community as to what a good coffee was, where one might get it in Balland, and whether it wouldn't be great to have a cafe in Balland that served good coffee. An article that appeared in the Age newspaper about Cafe Bohemia and the street coffee culture issue stirred up some further heated discussion around the town. Articles appeared in the local paper, and Wombat members were dubbed the Chardonnay Set. The Chardonnay Set. What a wonderful theme for promoting Wombat's forthcoming Bra exhibition, the organisation's autumn festival contribution for 2006. And the winners of the best float are, who else but the Chardonnay Set, created by Wombat and the Community House. The Bra exhibition, based on an exhibition Sarah Springfield had visited in Creswick, captured the imagination of many people, as witnessed in the variety of media and the wit displayed in the entries in the show. A community workshop was held prior to the event. Many of the decorated bras were made by local individuals, including entries from the men's shed. The exhibition was both a humorous and a serious look at bras, with some of the proceeds going to breast cancer. 2006 also saw the entry of Michael Bradley into the Wombat picture. As Lou Callow was working at the Bra exhibition, her for sale teapot house was being inspected by a potential buyer, Michael. It was bought, and then Sarah Springfield was approached to lease the house and run it as a cafe. All this happened on the weekend of the Bra exhibition. Within a few months, the Flying Teapot Cafe came into being. Wombat members being visible and heard at a council meeting over car parking and cafe issues. Wombat AGM 2006 at the Flying Teapot. Hard Drive Bluegrass Band from Blackwood entertained us. Further Cafe Bohemias were created in a tent to support both the Gordon Spring Festival and the Mount Edgerton Family Fun Day. Another project organised by Karen Hawkes was Inspirational Cinema. After the viewing of each film, Karen led interesting discussions. Wombat had become very successful in applying for grant money in partnership with groups such as the Community House. This particular grant saw the establishment of a costume wardrobe for community use at the Mechanics Institute. A series of costumes were designed by members of the Friday group and created by local community members Carol Callender and Margaret Hillier. This funding gave people who had difficulty participating in festivals an opportunity to be centre stage in the parade. The funding was received from the Department of Victorian Communities and worn in the Autumn Festival Parade by members of the disability group. The Wacky Shoe exhibition followed on from the Bra exhibition, and community members used shoes to create all sorts of wonderful works of art. Wombat added some artistic flair to the development of two Festival of Hope events coordinated by Jeff Kerverak from Balland District Health and Care and community members. This was a community event to assist people to acknowledge grief and loss. Wombat provided a fire sculpture as part of the festival. In 2007, Tor Roxburgh from Balland's Omnibus Art Gallery approached Wombat for the support to run a community portrait exhibition to feature local faces. Wombat took on the concept and obtained a grant from Regional Arts Victoria for Neighbours Painting Neighbours, an initiative which saw artist Ben Creaney supporting local people to have a go at portraiture, including community members living in the Balland Aged Care Hostel. The project culminated in the Frankie Bald Portrait Prize. This film night celebrated International Day of Disabilities. It was supported by Fiona Strawn from Rural Access Victoria. Balland filmmaker Carly Webb opened the evening and the audience viewed a number of short films created by artists with disabilities. The Masks and Mirrors exhibition held in the Mechanics Institute was another event run by Wombat to support the Autumn Festival. People of all ages and arts abilities created a wonderful range of art pieces. Wombat booked local band Via Medea, which played its first ever gig at the event. In keeping with Wombat's tradition of hosting fun AGMs and supporting local arts-based businesses, the 2008 AGM was held at Omnibus Art Gallery in Balland. Organised superbly by a Wombat subcommittee, the inaugural Masquerade Ball was a fundraiser for Balland and District Health and Care. A great amount of work went into the much-talked-about ball thanks to the efforts of Deb McLeod, Phil Henderson, Josh Pearson, Patrick Bonello and Carmel Hunter. Funding was partly sourced by a Moorabool Council Community Arts grant submission. This event was a spectacular success with stunning costumes and masks. It set the standard for future high-quality events in the Shire. The Wombat Artist Designer in Residence program was an initiative of Will and Tours. The residency program is ambitious and exists to support international artists to come and stay in Moorabool, develop networks with local artists and community members, and create new work, leaving behind an artwork as a gift for the Moorabool community. The inaugural Artist Designer in Residence was Ayob Bin Ismail from Nanyang Polytechnic School of Design in Singapore, who spent a month in Balland in 2009. Ayob's gift to the Shire is the Red Dot, which has been installed at the Moorabool Shire office in Balland. In 2009, Peter Blizzard's sculpture Moorabool Earth Totem was installed in English Street, Balland, along with chess storage seating and poster column, both of which were designed by Will Velislav Georgiev. The first stage of the Balland Urban Streetscape project focused on McLean's Reserve in the main street. Some years later, funds were available for the second stage of the streetscape, which included work at the front of the Mechanics Institute and work in front of the news agency. The project, managed by Lee McCallum and Sue Jones from the Moorabool Shire, included funds for our first public art piece and artist-designed street furniture. A panel of local people selected Peter's proposal and the sculpture came into being. Throughout the creation of the Earth Totem, Peter struggled with cancer. On a cold, wet, early morning in winter, the sculpture was finally installed, and although Peter was very sick, his passion and determination to see the sculpture finished was unwavering. Peter continues to be an inspiration for all of us. Over 10 years, Wombat has provided support to individuals and groups with grant opportunities and has auspiced many individuals' grant applications. Working with Moorabool Shire and Balannan District Health and Care, Wombat was successful in receiving funding from the state government for tents for community use. In spring of 2009, they were put to good use during an informal community picnic by the Werribee River. Inspired by Steve Kelly, who brought back photos of European ones from his trips, it was decided Balannan's Autumn Festival needed a hay bale couple to welcome visitors into town. Putting the hay bale people together was a massive logistics exercise that would not have been possible without the efforts of Carmel Hunter and Deb McLeod. Crossroads Trading lent us the hay bales and took on the job of putting them into position. The Wombat team turned out in force on the day, and people from far and wide commented on how good that they looked. This is Lou receiving the Victorian Sustained Contribution to the Arts Award at the Launceston Regional Arts Centre Conference in 2010. She took Sally to ensure that the event was adequately witnessed and celebrated. Wombats and teachers Kelly Matterford and Sarah Peckham spent several days in the local primary schools making weather vanes with senior kids, which culminated in a holiday workshop session making real ones at the community house.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They learn much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.